Here's the basic potter's tools you'll need. You'll need a cut-off wire, a potter's wooden tool, metal rib, sponge, and some well-wedged clay. This is about 1.5 to 2 pounds. Take the ball of clay and firmly attach it to the wheel head. Add water. As the wheel spins, it will create a slurry that will reduce the friction between the spinning wheel head, the ball of clay, and your hand. Now that you're certain that you've created a nice centered piece of clay, you're ready to start the opening process. Now you're going to take your thumb of your left hand and your index finger of your right hand, slowly push down so that you create the opening. Now we're ready to start and make the floor. You want to add a little water, crook your finger, start to slowly bring it out. This is going to create the floor. There's going to be some throwing lines left in there, and you want to smooth those throwing lines out, either using your fingers, a sponge, or a wooden tool. This is the last stage before you start to bring up the walls of the clay. You want to make sure that you've taken that sponge and centered that ring of clay just before you bring it up. Now that you've centered the clay again and you've made this truck tire shape, you're ready to get ready to bring the clay up. You need to take your index finger and make a little groove down at the bottom so that you have a ledge there so that you can use that to bring the clay up into a cone shape. You want to bring it up nice and evenly and stop just before you get to the top and compress that so that you have a nice even edge. Now you're going to be doing this step a few more times. You're going to go down at the base, make a little ridge, take that little ridge with your sponge, and you're going to bring it up nice and evenly, and you're going to take and leave a little extra clay at the top each time you pull, and you're going to compress that top edge. Thank you. Now that you've finished getting the walls the thickness that you want them to be, you're ready to start the shaping process using a rib. Place your rib down at the bottom of the cylinder next to the wheel head, and with firm but light pressure, press out from the inside into the rib while you raise your right and left hand up toward the top of the cylinder at the same rate. Now that I finished the rough shaping with the wooden rib, I'm going to take the metal rib and, varying its angle to the cylinder, I'm going to press out slightly from the inside, erasing any other marks or throwing lines or tool marks from the wooden rib. Now that you've used the wooden rib and the metal rib to do the shaping, you're ready to take away any excess clay at the foot of the cylinder down at the base where it meets the wheel head. Take the pointy part of the sculptor's wooden tool, run it along the side of the cylinder down to the bottom where the wheel head and the cylinder meet, cutting away any excess clay that's down there. Then take the wooden tool, turn it almost horizontally, and run it underneath so that you undercut the cylinder just a little bit so that you have space now that you can run the potter's wire underneath without having the wire come up and cut away any unnecessary clay.